Welcome back. In this video, we're going to start looking at lifecycle management. Now, this is a beast of a thing. We can do everything from patching hosts, upgrading products, to even just installing products. Because we've just started on this VCF adventure, we're going to look at deploying the Lifecycle Manager, which is required for all the vRealize suite. All right, let's get started. Okay, a few things need to happen to sync with the repository. Firstly, that is me. I am getting older and older, but let's move on from that. First, log into the SDDC Manager. Make sure you've got an account that's got access to the VMware repository. Plug it in, and then it will start syncing and you can download the bundles you require. Once that's complete, we can then push the required bundle or deploy it to the vSphere cluster or the SDDC management domain. Okay, let's move on and get to it.
Get your Customer Connect VMware account details ready because we will have to populate them in the My VMware account page. So let's do that first. Once you've populated them, hit authorize and it will automatically validate and do everything it needs to do for you.
On that note, I wanted to quickly mention there is an offline way or method to get bundles. It's called the offline bundle tool, and it's really meant for dark sites and all that sort of stuff. Just keep it in the back of your mind. This isn't the only way. You don't need internet all the time. You will have a way out if you do need one.
Now that that is done, SDDC Manager will start to sync inventory or bundles upstream with the VMware resources. It may take some time, but it will eventually populate with bundles that are available. It can be a little confusing to understand which version of a product you need to deploy for the version of VCF you've got. In this case, we've got VCF 4.5, as you can see on the screen. Now, how do you identify the correct package versions? One way to do it is to use release versions, which is on the left-hand side. It will tell you all your domains and what version they're currently at. It'll also tell you what the BOM is and the recommended versions or the product versions you should deploy. The one thing I will note is 8.8.2 for Lifecycle Manager is flexible with VCF 4.4 and above, and I'll show you that link now. This is a table for all versions of VCF 4.4 and above that lists the compatible vRealize product versions. So if I scroll down, you can see at the bottom row, VCF 4.5 supports version 8.10 of Lifecycle Manager, and the maximum supported vRealize suite products is 8.10.x. That's good to know. Keep this in the back of your mind, especially if you're deploying this version of VCF. Now that more bundles have started to appear, we should be able to see the version of Lifecycle Manager that we want to deploy. We can see right in front of us that 8.8.2 is there. That's good. Something else to watch out for is, in the availability status, you can see install only bundle. Sometimes you'll see an upgrade only bundle. This will play impact when you go to deploy products, all that sort of stuff. If it's a fresh install, it needs to be the install only bundle. If you're upgrading versions, it needs to be the upgrade version, upgrade bundle. So just keep that in mind as well. If we click on vRealize Suite now, it tells us that we don't have a bundle, install bundle available to deploy vRealize Suite. We need to make sure we do that before we come back here and actually try to deploy it. Let's go back to bundle management and download that package so we can move on with this video. It took a little bit of time, somewhere around half an hour for me, but that package is now downloaded. To deploy the Lifecycle Manager, scroll down to vRealize Suite on the left-hand side. I'll click on deploy here.
It'll show you a couple of prerequisites. DNS and IP allocation, I've been mentioning that since the start of this series. Network configuration for vRealize and the installation package, which we've downloaded. Once you're good with that, select all and hit begin. On the next screen, you can see the appliance details or summary of its network configuration. All of this is automatic. You don't need to put any of this in. Review it and hit next. Click on next. I'll populate these details and then we'll continue on. Now that they're populated, let's walk through them together.
FQDN, fairly straightforward, I won't explain that. This is the one that actually confuses people. NSX-T T1 gateway. It's got an IP address, and if you recall, the cross region already had a gateway address. So it was 10.100.0.1, which is part of the AVN. So let's have a look at that. So we've logged in, I'll go into networking, go to segments. We can see under the cross region, 10.100.0.1 was the gateway that we created when defining the AVNs. What's actually happening here is we're going to be creating another gateway on the same network, and it's going to assign this IP address, and then a static route is going to be created back to the primary T1 gateway, if you want to call it that. And essentially this one is going to be used as load balancing for the vRealize suite. This will all make a bit more sense as we move through the process and it actually deploys. Let's continue on. Passwords, fairly straightforward. I won't explain those. I'll hit next now. This is a summary of everything that we've configured so far. Just make sure everything is correct for your environment. Again, this IP address here is not the IP address for this DNS record. this is an IP address of the new gateway that's being created, and this will be resolved automatically as part of the workflow. You'll see what I mean in a second. So now it's validating. We'll let that complete and it should tell us if it's good or not. If there are any issues, it will come back and let us know. The validation was successful and then automatically started deploying. That workflow has completed. We can see at the top here, deploy vRealize Lifecycle Manager successful. I did want to show you quickly the steps that I needed to go through to complete this. I won't go through everything individually, but there's quite a few steps. I wanted to point out, so you can see the NSX-T tier 1 gateway, FQDNs, IP addresses, it does a valid IP check, make sure there's no duplicate IP addresses, and then your static route, as I mentioned earlier. So now if I go into NSX-T, we can actually see what it's done. An additional T1 gateway, as I mentioned earlier, we'll see a static route, and it's a default route. I won't explain what default routes in this, but it's a default route pointing to a next hop of the actual gateway, which is on the WLD T1, which was created as part of the initial bring up and then the AVNs that were deployed. Okay, so now if we do a quick topology check,
we can see there's a new T1 gateway here. The segment is connected to two T1 gateways, the original WLD T1 and the new one that was just created, and it's plumbed to both. That's essentially all I wanted to show you here. It's a bit easier to visualize these things than just see them in configuration.
We can see the IP address that was set here. Remember, we didn't actually put this IP address in anywhere. It was resolved and then placed or entered automatically for us for the appliance. If you go back into the SDDC Manager, click on vRealize Suites, and this screen has now changed. Instead of saying deploy, it's got all the options of deploying workspace access, operations, login site, automation.
And there you have it. We've started with Lifecycle Manager, we've deployed vRealize Suite. Again, it's just the basics and the beginning. We will get through more and more as we progress. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. It really does help me out. And if you've missed it, you do need AVNs, which you can see how to configure in this video. And prior to that, you do need edge classes, which you can see in that video. See you in the next video. Thank you.